Love Factory.
The Love Factory, where we promote love and unity, helping relationships succeed. The Love Factory is brought to you by Uncle Wynn's Music Production, Inc. Hi, I'm Uncle Wynn, your host for tonight on The Love Factory. In the absence of my loved one, precious love, she's still under the weather, so y'all send her some love. This place here is where all the facets of love and relationship can be explored, whether personal, community, or love and romance. It's a place where love can be thoroughly examined to find meaningful solutions on how to revitalize and strengthen relationships that would enable them to flourish into a healthy, stable, and loving experience. We're going to go to one more song now by Stevie Wonder, All I Do.
Me. And let me tell you, girl, I don't be
Love Factory.
The LUV Factory. Welcome back to the Love Factory. I'm Uncle Wynn. I'm your host. And all I do is think about this evening is my wonderful, precious love who's at home under the covers. I'm sending you love, babe. Sending you love. Yeah, we're going to get to this part of our show here where we often talk about random acts of kindness. But I have something here that the universe gave me earlier today. I want to read this. And I titled it, The Ultimate Rule in the Act of Kindness. It is the desire, the best for all mankind, with the same degree of desire one have for oneself. Let us show love the way we want to be loved. Let us be happy for others in the same degree we want happiness shown towards us. Let us desire the same measure of success for others that we have for ourselves. Knowing that when we do, we attract the same measure unto ourselves. Let us affirm and release whatsoever things are pure, righteous, and lovely, wishing only the highest good for our fellow man. In the same way as wishing the highest good for one's own self, let kindness be our goal and love our religion. And so it is. Yes, yes. Welcome back to the Love Factor. I'm Uncle Wynn, your host this evening. Thank you for joining us. We're going to move on. We're getting ready now. I heard that our speaker is on the line. Hey, are you there, Reverend?
Well, I'm doing very well. Thank you for having me. I really think it's a great honor to be on your show tonight.
I'm so glad to have you, ladies and gentlemen. This is Reverend Marilyn Redmond. And we've been going back and forth with emails, and here we are. It's time to do it, Reverend.
I'm really eager about the whole thing.
Oh, okay. I just want to read just a little part of her bio here so you guys can kind of familiar with her. She is a counselor that helps others achieve their highest gifts and capabilities in all parts of their lives. She has experience moving beyond her 30-year domestic violence marriage of rape into a relationship of unconditional love. She has the knowledge and the wisdom to share with others on how to make a relationship work. She became a counselor to help others achieve their highest gifts and capabilities in all parts of their lives. Her newest book, Finding Reality Beyond Fear, has the steps to move you forward in life into unconditional love. So, ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome Reverend Marilyn Redmond.
Well, thank you for the nice introduction.
You're more than welcome. I am so glad to have you. I was going over your material, and we've been going back and forth, so I was just looking forward to speaking with you and getting you on the show and just let you just go ahead and tell what you're doing, you know, how the universe has been using you. So the audience and I, we're all ears. Welcome.
Oh, how wonderful to have a free reign. Well, I had to learn from experience. I think that's probably the best teacher, and some people like to run away from that experience, and when I was a young child, exactly is what I did. I was raised in domestic violence with a lot of abuse, and that's all I knew. And I did go to church for 50 years, and I thought that I was doing all the right things, but I discovered I was emotionally bankrupt. Mm-hmm. And when you are raised in a lot of abuse, you learn to defend yourself, and that's the problem. You're trying to protect yourself, and you actually, in that protection build, in my case, I built a shell around me. I wasn't going to open it up and get hurt again. But what I didn't open up to was the love of the universe because I'm defending myself. So I had to literally change that defense and that fear, guilt, and shame that I was raised in. So I had to move into a new path of love and learn to embrace it and to actually be around it and then get used to, as my friend said, Marilyn, you're going to get used to being around a healthy person when I met the fellow I'm with today. So, you know, I wasn't used to being in a loving relationship, and so I kept throughout my marriage, I found someone in college that was raised similarly to me, and we were two wounded little children trying to make it in an adult world without any living skills and not understanding how that we were just perpetuating the marriages of our parents, and we didn't know how to do it differently because they can't model what they don't know and can't show us love if they can't love themselves. And so even though, you know, we were both had gone to churches, different churches in different cities, we didn't meet till college, but, we just didn't have the skills and the tools and the information and the knowledge in those days, and my life just kept getting worse and worse, and because it was just a remake of the domestic violence and abuse I was raised in. So I was trying suicide to get out of the marriage, and he was trying to kill me. And one night, we'd been on vacation, and things had gone pretty well on the vacation, and he wanted to celebrate and have a drink, and being alcoholics, that did not work. So that night, I knew I was not going to get home alive. And so I prayed out of my heart, which was unfamiliar because in the church I always prayed out of the hymnal. So this time, just spontaneously, I said, God, please help me. I really don't want to die. And quickly he was off the road, passed out over the wheel, and one thing led to another. God seems to step in and take you where you need to be, and I found out about spiritual support groups, 12-step groups. You know, I ended up at counseling and classes that taught healthy behaviors and all kinds of understanding of what needed to change. And what I needed to change was me. What I discovered is what you send out is what comes back. There are universal laws, and what goes around comes around. That's the current way of expressing it. Love attracts love, and of course, fear attracts fear. And he was very fear-based, and I was very fear-based. And we had attracted exactly what each of us was. And so at one point, I do a lot of meditation, and the silent voice said, Marilyn, you're going to have to become the person you want in your life for a partner. And I could do that after I got divorced. And I finally had the ability, because I was no longer tied into making him happy, I could start to make myself happy. Mm-hmm. And I made a list of what I wanted in my life for a partner, and spirituality, honesty, loyalty, trustworthy, sincerity, and, the kinds of traits that we want in our lives, but I didn't know I didn't have them. I was trying to do it, but it was not on a conscious level. It was a very superficial, fear-based type of experience to look good to everybody, but it really didn't come from my heart. And so as I changed, gradually learning how to do the changing. And my first book is Paradigm Bust. My first book is Roses Have Thorns, which tells about my beginnings of why I needed to change. And then I have a book called Paradigm Busters, Reveal the Real You, which actually details all the steps and how you change your inner life to the love of who we truly are. And through doing that, I was able to move into a relationship with another person who, for the last over 16 years, I've received unconditional love. And what has happened is I was the scared little three-year-old in those days, old days, and this person has loved me until I could love myself and move up and become a mature grown-up. So what I've discovered is relationships are often based in two little kids trying to make it and fighting for who's going to be king. And so when you give up your being a little kid and your ego and your fear and all your needing to be right, people want to be right. Today I've discovered I'd rather be happy than right.
I know you're right.
And, so then we can go into harmony and I can come into balance. And it's two mature people coming together with respect for each other, caring for each other. It's not about self-searching. It's not about being self-centered or selfish. It's about being a love giver rather than a love taker. And the more I give, the more I get is what it boils down to. But my ex-husband was so damaged from his childhood, he couldn't do that. The psychiatrist doubted he would ever be able to face the fears of his childhood and the abuse of that. So fortunately, was in some spiritual study groups, and there was a gentleman in there that I really liked what I saw, and his behavior was very kind and caring. And I said to myself, that's the kind of person I would like in my life. And gradually, that's what happened, actually. So I changed, and my life changed.
Wow. That's a beautiful story. Now, I know you, do you, like, help out a lot of females, young ladies and stuff? Because this story here, a lot of them need to hear that.
Well, yes, I do. I try to help as many as I can. I'm in several volunteer situations where I can help young women because they don't always have the information and the experience. And God has made it possible to get, see, I have 7 years of college, so, and I'm growing up as, you know, physically I look like an adult, chronologically I look like an adult, but inside I had to grow up out of that childhood behavior from the past, and that's become my biggest gift, is the wisdom that has come out of understanding the changes I had to accomplish, and that's what all my writing is about. I have a lot of YouTubes. I have 10, well, the next book when it comes out, Finding Reality, will be my 10th book on Amazon.com.
Mm-hmm.
And I do counseling in my home and even on Skype. And so I do try to help as many people that are interested to, you know, people need to be ready to change their comfort zone and move out of their fear into a bigger, better horizon of love. And it's not an easy process. But the rewards of the good feelings inside is so worth it. It's so much better than being in depression and darkness, and coming into the light of the universe is a marvelous experience. And we all deserve it, and we all can do it if we're open to embrace it.
Right, right. That's the thing, you know. You got to be open to embrace it and be ready for change, because if you're not ready for change, you know, that's one of the key elements there, because I know as for myself, it's like these last 4 years, I was really saying, hey, you know, there's some things that I need to change now. I'm ready to give love unconditionally. So, you know, my partner, when I look at her, you know, I don't say, well, I'll love her once she's this way, or if she would change and be like this, you know, I say, hey, you know, it is what it is, and I love you anyway. So I understand the unconditional love, but I had to first start with myself.
Right, and one of the things, I have a little calendar that I give some of my clients, because this is what they need to look at. We do a nightly inventory of where did I miss the mark, and put a little minus on the calendar that's for that particular attitude or behavior or thinking, and then tomorrow try to do a better job of changing that into being a positive. How can I help somebody rather than be selfish? How can I be generous rather than greedy? And every night, you know, do a little check mark on the calendar and just see where you need to grow and change. And what really helped me was the 23rd Psalms. In Galatians, it's the gifts of the Spirit. And I started to try to encompass those on a, I would take one and try to practice it each week,
mm-hmm.
and I really noticed my life changing, because I was actually in the behavior of doing a loving act or thought or whatever was in front of me to do, rather than my old way. So, you know, if it was be kind, you mentioned that earlier to this during the program. You know, whatever I needed to change, I would try to practice it. And a lot of people read a lot of books. But if you don't actually apply it, then Right. Nothing's going to change, because in your head, nothing changes. You have to get into your heart for it to change.
Yeah, you have to be doers of the word, not just readers.
Exactly. Like Nike says, do it well. That's what you need to. You just jump in there and do it if you're afraid or not, because fear is actually an illusion. It's not real. If you do it anyway, there isn't any fear. The fear goes away.
Right, right, right. I love the way you... where you putting that, because even in my own life, you know, things around me that I look at, I say, well, I've accepted some things that I can't change, especially when it's other people
and exactly. Certain, I can't change
and certain other situations. So I say, well, if this bothering me, or if it's sort of like frustrated me or agitated me. I said, well, maybe I need to change in this area. So I start looking within and looking at that and just self-contemplate while I sit back and sort of picture myself sitting in a chair and say, now, you know, why am I feeling this way? Is this real or whatever? You know, once I come to terms with it, I say, a lot of times it'd be, yes, that's you. And I begin to deal when I, like you say, I start practicing being kind. I start practicing, hey, you know, you don't have to be right all the time. You know what I mean? So I'm with you when it comes to that. I'd rather be, hey, I don't have to be right. I just love peace.
Well, I've come to understand when those situations come up, I respond today. Instead of reacting fear, I say, what is the most loving thing for me and the other person? And I try to respond in a loving way that's going to bring solution and harmony. And people are out there as just friends I haven't met if I don't know them, or else the people I'm involved with personally and every day or whatever, they're actually my mirrors, and they're reflecting back to me with what I need to change. So those are areas of my life I don't love myself. And when we love ourselves, we can come back into being whole people. We don't have to have souls that are broken. We can mend our souls in the love of God and move into that grace. And that's maturity.
Okay. I got a question I want to ask, but I want to go take a break here and go into some music. And I got a question for you when we come back with Reverend Marilyn Redmond.
Love, I do it for love, 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 love. There'll be girls across the nation that'll eat this up. Babe, I know that it's your soul, but could you bottle it up? Get down to the heart of it. No, it's my heart. You're out of your luck. Don't make me tell you again, my love, 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 love. So I don't claim to know much, except soon as you start to make room for the parts that aren't you, it gets harder to bloom in a garden of love. Love, love, love. Love, 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 love. The only thing I ever could need, only one good thing worth trying to be, and it's love. Could you kindly shut up? Get started at keeping your part of the bargain. Oh, please, little darling, you're killing me sweetly with love. Love, love, love. Love, 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 love. Only thing I ever could need, only one good thing worth trying to be, and it's love.
Welcome back to the Love Factory, where we're talking with our special guest here, Reverend Marilyn Redmond, and she's on the line, and I have a question for you there.
I am sure here.
Okay. let me see how I'm going to say this. When a person began to love themselves first unconditionally, from my experience, I had to look at all my strong points, my weak points, my character flaws and all this stuff. And I had to take them all and gather them all and say, you know what? This is me, but I still love myself. With all those things, I have time to work on and to release and better myself. So is that sort of the way someone that's want to really work on themselves first of all, starting to love themselves, that they have to accept their whole self? What do you think? Give me some enlightenment on that.
Well, that's a very good question, because you really hit upon the heart of the situation. I have to really identify and release all those negative feelings and traits, communication, behaviors. And I've actually, in my Paradigm Busters book, have you list them out. And then, because if you continue those, you're giving away your power to, if it's other people or situations, and you're giving your power to them. So if you can look at yourself and say, where am I being selfish? Where am I being dishonest? Where am I being self-seeking? And who am I being inconsiderate to? And the bottom line is, you're being inconsiderate to yourself when you're in those spaces, because you're separated from God's love. So to give them up, now you can ask God to remove those situations and replace them with love and grace. And actually, the love and grace will start filling into the empty spaces as those negative feelings and attitudes change. And I'll never forget the time in Death Valley when I was meditating and I felt grace for the first time from head to toe. And I knew, you know, I was onto something and I wanted more. And so for over 32 years, I every day tend to identify in an inventory at night, that little calendar I told you about, where do I still need to make some more growth? Where do I still need to be more generous or kind or caring? Where can I be more helpful? And where did I miss the mark that day? So I keep growing, and it's been a gradual thing, because the fear is really a dark blanket that stops the sunlight of God's love. And so I have to poke holes through that fear and let the light come in. And as that happens, I start, in my case, it's kind of like God loved me so I could finally love myself. And God put a person in my life who channels that love to me to support me in that growth. So it kind of goes together, you know. You love yourself and share it, but my love comes from God. And when I started to feel good, and in meditation I was told with a silent voice that there's nothing wrong with you and there never has been, and you are a good person, I finally was hearing good. I'm a big believer in affirmations to help replace the false information I was fed as a child, that you're worthless, you're not worth anything, you're not good enough. All those old messages have to be replaced. And when God told me I was a good person, it just kind of like made all the difference in the world. I could start to love myself.
Yes, I mean, you said it in a nutshell there, because something you just said, I've read somewhere where the writer was saying, leave yourself alone. You're good. You're okay. Because a lot of times we take on like baggage all through the years, from a childhood all the way up to, you know, till we're grown, really. And once we know how to release all those things, and then we really become knowing who we really are, that perfect part of us is saying, hey, look, you know, just work on those mental flaws and everything, our way of thinking. And once we change our way of thinking, then we can really see that bright light that shines behind, I always say, that light behind the veil. I mean, we begin to live out of that. So that's what has made a big difference in my life. And a lot of the things that you're saying, I can relate to. Thank you so much for that, for sharing that.
Well, one of the ways that people can probably achieve that a little easier, it's taken me a long time, but if you think of yourself this happened to me literally. I was in an airplane on the tarmac waiting to take off. I was heading to a writer's conference in California, and it was raining terribly. It was dark, and heavy, heavy, heavy rain, and the flat surface of the airfield before the plane took off actually had puddles. I mean, it was flat, but it was raining so hard there were puddles in it. And I said, oh, my gosh, it's raining cats and dogs. I mean, you know that slogan. Mm-hmm. And so, but as the plane progressed upwards through the clouds, above the clouds was the sunshine. And there was absolutely no rain. It was perfect sunshine, bright and sunny. And what I realized is God is always there shining. There might be rainy days, but God is always up there shining. And so there's never going to be problems. God's there when you get past the problems, the challenges that you have to. We all are growing up. Mm-hmm. And when we get past the challenges and move into that sunlight, it's unconditional and it's everlasting and it's always been there and always will.
So you're saying, you know, that the sun is always shining. It's just the clouds that block it. We just got to rise up above so we can see.
Yes, exactly.
Oh, okay. All right, we're going to go one more song here. Bob Marley, One Love. We're going to come back. So get ready to give your information on how people can reach you and all that good stuff and find your product.
Oh, wonderful. Thank you.
With the Love Factory. I'm your host, Win Thompkins, and in the absence of my love precious, we are going to move on now. I have some space here for Reverend to give all her information for his contact and product and all that stuff there. So there you go. Tell the audience where they can find your services and everything.
I would love to. My website is angelicasgifts.com. My main angel is Angelica, besides Archangel Michael. And so angelicasgifts.com shows the many hats I wear, which is quite a few. My books are at amazon.com. I have 10 books and e-books. They're all about, if you take my information, will help your relationships, because it's all about finding the success of who you are inside and sharing that with your partner. And when you release your ego, you and your partner don't have ego. There's going to be harmony in your relationship, and that's what my writing's about, is how you do that. And we've been talking about that tonight. I have a blog, MarilynRedmondBooks.blogspot.com. And I have over 100 videos and interviews and spiritual information on YouTube. And so if you Google YouTube Google YouTube or Google my name, you'll find a lot of different varieties of articles and books and so forth. So angelicasgifts.com is my website, and Google my name or look for my blog and lectures on YouTube. And I, you know, everything I do is to help people come together in harmony and balance. And there is ways to do it. It's just understanding that the love is in our hearts. And when we open our hearts, it shares with others. And not to be afraid to move out of our old comfort zone and just, like we said earlier, just do it. You're going to have a bigger, brighter life that is much more enjoyable and brings lots of rewards. And the more I help people, the better my life gets, because we're sharing, and what we share expands and makes our life and love grow.
Well, I mean, you said it all, and it's like, I just want you to take just a couple of more minutes and to share with the audience, you know, a closing or something that you want to leave with them, very special. And we're going to give you the time to do that right now. So you got still got the floor. Go ahead.
Well, thank you. I'm not prepared for this, but I guess the thing I found the most was, no matter what had happened in my past, which I was literally a Cinderella when my mother remarried, I was the stepdaughter. And I had all the chores and my sister got all the goodies. But, you know, not to live in that past. Let the past go. It's over. You can't recreate it. You can't do it over. It's history, and it happened, but what did you learn from it? What were the lessons that you could do differently this time than what you did before? And let that all go so you can live in the moment. Live in the now. That's where the joy is. That's where the love is. That's where reality is. Right now, you're in reality. The past is an illusion. It's no longer valid. It's gone. And so if you're living in reality, you're living in the love and presence of God, and you are in joy, and open your heart for gratitude, and when your heart is open, more comes. And so the more we're grateful, the better our lives get.
I like that when you said the now, because I have to remind myself, you can't live in the past, you can't live in the future. It's like you're swinging back and forth. I mean, that can get you into a lot of trouble, because you worry about regrets from the past, and then you're worrying about your future, you know, fears of the future. So it's really, like you say, it's all an illusion. So if we can learn to stay in the moment, in the now, I mean, once I've learned that, you know, more I practice that, the better off I am. And I'm glad that you mentioned it, because I know a lot of people, it's either one of the two. They worried about the past or they fear the future. But you know, once I've learned to live in the now, I found my happiness, my joy, and just, there's no place like the now, and I'm glad you mentioned that.
Well, thank you, because I've found out, you know, my head is out to do me in, and I don't have to listen to those voices in my head. I can move from my head into my heart, where the love is, and how can I help someone else? Because, you know, God gives me everything I need. Mm-hmm. I've not ever gone hungry, fortunately, in my life. I have always had a roof over my life, and I have a car where I can, you know, in this case, I help a person who doesn't have a car. I help her several times a week so she can get where she needs to be. So go out and help somebody. It's going to make your life expand, and you're going to be so much better off. Find a community project that you can participate in. Find a nursing home where somebody doesn't have relatives that come to see them anymore. Mm-hmm. Go out there and make a life. You know, people sit home and say, I'm so depressed. Well, get a life. You know, if you're just going to sit there and be in the dark, then, you know, turn on the light and go find things that you can benefit by helping other people. And that expands your life and it brightens it up, and it will brighten up others too.
Okay, now that's a word there, because just today I was thinking, you know, I was watching something and it came and it was showing some homeless people and stuff. I said, well, wow, you know, it's a great thing if I just can, I'm just going to make some time to just, even if it's just an hour to a week, you know, to go out and help serve, you know, because I know that there's nothing like giving. I mean, the joy you receive when you give like that. So I thank you very much for coming on and sharing from your heart, and we're going to ask that, you know, that we get you back on the show, that you would come back and just share. You know, that's why I just told you got the flow, you know, just because I know when people tell me that, even if I'm going out somewhere to sing, sometimes they say, hey, it's your flow. So that means that you're allowing the universe just to be free, just to come out and just say what it wants to say. And just, I thank you for this little moment and this time that you shared with us. And we here at the Love Factory, I'm going to say thank you for Precious. I'm going to say thank you for the audience. And we would love having you back. And if there's anything you want to say before you go, I mean, we just appreciate you.
Oh, well, God loves us all. We're all in the same spirit, and we're all brothers and sisters, and let's treat each other as if we are.
All righty, there you have it. Ladies and gentlemen, that was Reverend Marilyn Redmond. Thank you so much. We're going to go out with the OJ's Love Train. Thank you for joining the Love Factory this evening. In the absence of my love, we still went on without her, but I know she's listening and her prayers is headed this way too. We thank you for our audience and everyone that listened to us and joined the show. And if you'd like to reach us, you can reach us on Facebook under the Love LUV Factory and Uncle Wynn's Music Inc. So until the next time, you guys just keep on loving and loving each other and sharing the Love Factory.
People I can breathe. I gave away my money and now we don't even speak. I drove miles and miles, but would you do the same for me? Honestly. offered up my shoulder just for you to cry upon. Gave you constant shelter and a bed to keep you warm. They gave me the heartache, and in return I gave a song. It goes on and on. Life can get you down, so I just numb the way it feels. I'll drown it with a drink and out-of-date prescription pills. And all the ones that love me, they just left me on the shelf. No farewell. So before I save someone else, I've got to save myself. I gave you all my energy and I took away your pain. 'Cause human beings are destined to radiate or drain. What line do we stand upon? 'Cause from here it looks the same. And only scars remain. Life can get you down, so I just numb the way it feels. I'll drown it with a drink and out-of-date prescription pills. And all the ones that love me.
Hi, everybody. Join me, Win Thompkins, and my co-host, Precious Love, every Thursday night at 10 p.m. for the Love Factory Show, where we and our guests discuss and promote love in all its forms, self-love, community love, family love, plus love and relationship. That's every Thursday at 10 p.m. Join us on the Love Factory Show here on the Tan Talk Radio Network.
Like that. Oh, I'm here again. Between the devil and the danger, but I guess it's just my nature. My dad was wrong, 'cause I'm not like my mom. 'Cause she just smiled and I'm complaining in a song. But it helps. So before I save someone else, I've got to save myself. Life can get you down, so I just numb the way it feels. I'll drown it with a drink and out-of-date prescription pills. And all the ones that love me, they just left me on the shelf. Oh, farewell. So before I save someone else, I've got to save myself. And before I blame someone else, I've got to save myself. And before I love